Hello everyone, I am Mangesh Kulkarni from Candid Advisors. This video is regarding stock analysis of MCX, Multi Commodity Exchange. I am going to invest in this stock for long term. So I thought I should shoot a video and share the logic behind the stock selection and the financial parameters, financial performance of this company and what are the triggers. What is the potential expectation from this company and how it will impact the stock price. So let's quickly go to the presentation. Before going to presentation, this is our company profile. You can visit our website www.candidadvisor.in, and we are into mutual funds and wealth management. Before proceeding, this is a standard disclaimer. This video is only for educational purpose. Please don't consider it as a recommendation or advice. Please do consult your financial advisor and do proper due diligence before taking any financial decision. This is the strategy with which I am identifying stocks for long-term investment, and this is the performance of the stocks that I have invested into. As you can see, there are 21 stocks that I have invested in, and some of the stocks like Tata Elxsi, our buy price was 1287. Currently stock is trading at 3480 and it has given a very decent profit of 170%. And Meghmani Organics was recommended, was bought on 30th September 2020 at a price of 80 rupees per share. Stock is currently trading at 141. So this is the full performance of the stocks, and I have shared the stock name, the date on which it was bought, the buy price, current price and current status of the investment, whether it is profitable or loss making as of today. We have generated annualized profit of approximately 54% as of today. This is the same bifurcation of the stocks. Top three performers are Tata Elxsi, Dynamic Products and Meghmani Organics. Top three losers are RVNL, that is Rail Vikas Nigam Limited, and Solar Industries and Mahanagar Gas. So the uniqueness of this strategy is the losses will be small and the profits will be bigger as compared to loss making stocks. So overall, we can make decent money out of this strategy. Now let's come to the profile of Multi Commodity Exchange, that is MCX. MCX is an commodity exchange in India. Basically, it offers trading for trading in gold, silver futures, then other metals like copper and aluminium and other agri commodities. This company came with an IPO in February 2012, and it is the only exchange that is listed in India. Of course, now we have IEX also, Indian Energy Exchange, but MCX is the first exchange that was listed. Now MCX is being regulated by SEBI. Earlier it was regulated by FMC, Forward Markets Commission. Now it is being regulated by SEBI. Mr. P.S. Reddy is the MD and CEO of the company, and he is going to continue to be on this position till 2024. Now this is recent trigger for MCX. SEBI has permitted stock exchanges to launch options for commodity derivatives segment, and in line with this decision, MCX has launched gold mini options of 100 grams. So this is going to be a new trigger for additional revenue generation. Let's quickly go to the financial highlights. We are going to see the financial performance of this company for last 10 years, right from 2011 2020. So as you can see, the Excel I have mentioned profit after tax that MCX has posted in this last 10 years. So 2011, the profit after tax was 170 crores, 173 crores. Then in 2012, it was 286, then 299, 153, 125, 114, 126. So up to 2017, the profit came down. There are several reasons for this decline in profits, but from 2019 onwards, the profits are on a upward trajectory. So overall average growth of profit from 2011 to 2020, it is 3.15. So it is not that good. Company has posted average below average growth in profits. Then PAT margin in 2011, the profit after tax margin was 46.8%. Then 54, 57, 44, 56, 48, 48, 41, 48, and 63. So average profit margin is 50.58, which is very, very decent in this current competitive world. Posting a profit after tax margin of 50% is something very decent. And coming to return on equity, for long-term investors, return on equity is very important. In 2011, the return on equity was 20%, then 28, 25. In 2014, it was 11%. 2015, it was 9%, then 7, 9, 8. 2014 to 2018 was a tough patch for this year, for this company. And from 2019 onwards, everything is improving. So we have to take note of both the things. From 2014 to 18, the time was tough, and from 19 onwards, the performance is improving. So we can hope for this continuation of this improvement in performance. Average return on equity is 14.5, which is again not bad. Coming to growth in shareholder funds, in 2011, the total reserves and shareholders funds was 845 crores, and in the last 10 years, from 845, we have come to 1360 crores. So approximately annualized growth is 4.9%. So again, this is a below average growth in shareholders funds, but there is a reason for this below average growth in shareholders funds. The reason is the company is paying decent amount of dividends. So if you can notice, on an average, the company has paid 40 to 45% of its net profit as a dividend. So the reason behind this is that company does not need capital for future growth because it is a asset-light business model, and for growth in the revenue or for growth in net profit, they don't need any capital. So we have to note this, that the dividend payout ratio is very good. Coming to the debt of the company, is not having a single rupee of loan. So long-term debt is zero for all the 10 out of 10 years, which is again a very positive thing for us as a investors. There are certain other points that we have to note. This is the market share of MCX in various segments. In precious metals and stones, the market share of MCX is almost 99.9, that is almost 100%. Then in energy, it is 100%. Base metals, it is 100%. In agri commodities, it is 22.1%. The contribution of each segment in MCX turnover, precious metals दैट इज गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर कंट्रीब्यूट ऑलमोस्ट 58%. सो द प्राइजेस ऑफ गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर, वॉट इज द मूवमेंट इन प्राइजेस ऑफ गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर MCX. एंड इन द लास्ट 1.5 और 2 ईयर्स प्राइजेस ऑफ गोल्ड हैव रिजन अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 50 to 60%. सो दैट इज अ गुड न्यूज़ फॉर MCX. इन एनर्जी कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 21% ऑफ द टर्न ओवर. दैन बेस मेटल्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट 18% एंड एग्री कमोडिटीज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इज नेग्लिजिबल. एज आई सेड, बिकॉज ऑफ द राइज इन गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर प्राइजेस, एवरेज डेली टर्न ओवर हैज़ इंक्रीज्ड सब्सटेंशियली फ्रॉम फाइनेंशियल ईयर 19. अगेन इन फाइनेंशियल ईयर 20 इट वॉज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 32,000, विच इज़ अ ग्रोथ ऑफ 30% ईयर ऑन ईयर. एंड इन फाइनेंशियल ईयर 21 ऑल्सो इट इज इन द रेंज ऑफ 32,000. दिस आर द मेजर शेयर होल्डर्स. सो टू शेयर होल्डर्स वी हैव टू टेक नोट ऑफ. फर्स्ट वन इज द कोटक महिंद्रा बैंक. सो अगेन दिस गिव्स मी कम्फर्ट बिकॉज रेप्यूटेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक कोटक महिंद्रा बैंक हैज़ अ 15% स्टेक इन MCX. एंड अगेन सीरियल नंबर 4 मिस्टर राकेश झुंझुनवाला इज ऑल्सो होल्डिंग 4% ऑफ दिस कंपनी, दैट इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 300 करोर्स ऑफ शेयर्स. एंड आई थिंक मिस्टर झुंझुनवाला हैज़ बॉट मोर 5 लाख शेयर्स, और आई एम नॉट श्योर ऑफ द अबाउट क्वान्टिटी, बट ही हैज़ इंक्रीज हिज स्टेक इन MCX रिसेंटली. दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट इज़ अ एसेट लाइट मॉडल. सो एज द रेवेन्यू गोज अप, द ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसिस डज नॉट इंक्रीज दैट इन दैट प्रोपोर्शन. सो ऑपरेटिंग ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसिस डिवाइडेड बाय रेवेन्यू, दैट इन टर्म्स ऑफ परसेंटेज इट इज कंटिन्यूअसली कमिंग डाउन. एंड इन फ्यूचर ऑल्सो एज द रेवेन्यू इंक्रीजेस, द एक्सपेंसेस विल नॉट इंक्रीज इन दैट इन द सेम प्रपोर्शन. सो दैट विल लीड टू डिसप्रपोर्शनेट इंक्रीज इन बॉटम लाइन, दैट इज प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स. तो लेट मी शेयर द रैशनल बिहाइंड द स्टॉक सिलेक्शन. इफ यू हैव नोटिस, एज वी हैव सीन द फाइनेंशियल पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द कंपनी, द 10 ईयर परफॉर्मेंस इज नॉट दैट गुड, दैट इज क्लियर फ्रॉम द नंबर्स. सो इफ द फाइनेंशियल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द कंपनी इज नॉट गुड फॉर लास्ट 10 ईयर्स, सो वाई वी आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन दिस स्टॉक. सो द रैशनल बिहाइंड द स्टॉक सिलेक्शन इज दैट इन लास्ट 3 to 4 months, और फॉर दैट मैटर 6 months, मेनी एक्सपर्ट्स आर एंटिसिपेटिंग अ मल्टी ईयर बुल रन इन कमोडिटीज. एंड देर इज अ एविडेंस टू दिस थियरी बिकॉज ऑल द कमोडिटी प्राइजेस आर अप 20 to 25% इन लास्ट 3 months, एंड इट इज अ वर्ल्ड वाइड फिनोमेनॉन. सो इफ दिस थियरी कम्स ट्रू, और लेट्स से देर इज अ मल्टी ईयर फॉर लाइक 3 to 5 ईयर्स ऑफ बुल रन इन कमोडिटीज, दैट विल लीड टू इंक्रीज ट्रेडिंग एक्टिविटी इन कमोडिटी सेगमेंट. तो एवरेज डेली टर्न ओवर इन कमोडिटीज, और फॉर दैट मैटर ऑन कमोडिटी एक्सचेंजेस, विल इंक्रीज. एंड एज वी हैव सीन इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंस टू रेवेन्यू चार्ट, द लीनियर इंक्रीज इन रेवेन्यूज विल लीड टू एक्सपोनेंशियल इंक्रीज इन प्रॉफिट्स फॉर MCX, दैट इज द एक्सपेक्टेशन. नाउ वेदर दिस ग्लोबल मल्टी ईयर बुल रन इन कमोडिटीज विल हैपन और नॉट, दैट वी डोंट नो. एंड एज अ इन्वेस्टर देर इज अ फेवरेबल रिस्क रिवॉर्ड बिकॉज स्टॉक हैड हिट अ ऑल टाइम हाई ऑफ अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 1950 रुपीज, एंड करेंटली इट इज ट्रेडिंग एट आई थिंक 1450 और समथिंग इन द रेंज ऑफ 1500 रुपीज. सो ऑलरेडी द स्टॉक इज डाउन 20% फ्रॉम इट्स ऑल टाइम हाई, एंड देर इज अ लिमिटेड डाउन साइड इन द स्टॉक प्राइस, लेट्स से 35 to 40%, बिकॉज ऑफ 3 रीजन्स. द फर्स्ट रीजन इज पैट मार्जिन इज वेरी हाई फॉर दिस कंपनी, देन द कंपनी इज पेइंग वेरी हाई डिविडेंड पे आउट. एज ऑफ टूडे द डिविडेंड यील्ड इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 2%. सो दिस विल इंश्योर दैट द स्टॉक प्राइस डज नॉट फॉल मोर देन 40-50%. And the other plus point is the company is zero debt. So if things move in our favor, stock can double in next 5 years. That is my expectation from the company. And risk of 35 to 40% and reward of 100 or 120% in 5 years. So that makes a decent risk reward of 1:3. So this is the rationale as per the risk reward ratio. I think this will turn out to be a good investment. So let's hope for the best. This was all about MCX. And coming to valuations, current price is 1476. Market cap is 7528, 7528 crores. And this is something to take note of. India's biggest commodity exchange is available at 7500 crores. So it is very difficult to believe that the only commodity exchange in India is available at such a low valuation. So in terms of macro opportunity, there is a long way to go for MCX. In terms of price to earnings, the company's stock price is available at approximately 30 times of current earnings. Price to book wise, it is available at 5.54. Debt to equity is zero because company is not having any debt on the books. Dividend yield is approximately 2%. So that's all about MCX. We offer following services: mutual funds and SIP, portfolio management services, AIF. Then we offer demat account of ICICI Direct, Kotak Securities and Upstox. Then we also have stock market courses. These are the details of our stock market courses. We have fundamental analysis, then technical analysis and advanced course. So you can visit our website www.candidadvisor.in for further details. So that's all from my side. You can contact me on this number, and I hope this video will add some value to your wealth creation journey. Happy investing. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye.